welcome to this video. Today I'm going to show you how to install the Suckless tools, DWM and Dmenu and ST from the void packages. Okay, first of all we need to get the void packages by just doing a git clone. Of course you have to have git for this, https github.com/void-linux/void packages.git. Okay. It's gonna take a little bit of time, depends on your internet connection. I'll come back when it's done. Hello again, the download is completed, so I'm gonna list. As you can see here, I have downloaded the void packages. Before going into it, you have to install the xorg server and some dependency, as you can see, libxfte and libx11 and libxinama and base deval. Of course you have to install git, that's before this, and some font. I just installed terminus font. Okay, let's go to cd into void packages. I list the content. We have the source packages and xbps-src. Now we have to bootstrap the binaries. Just do .xbps and autocomplete and binary that dash boot strap, and it's gonna take a little bit of time. It's going to download all these dependencies. I'll come back when it finishes. And now, after the downloading the dependencies and bootstrapping the binaries, as you can, if I list, I can see. Let me list this. Okay, now we can install DWM and STN Dmenu. Let me just list to see if DWM. Let me grab and DWM. We are listing the source packages and we found DWM. Let me list for Dmenu. Dmenu. Okay, we have Dmenu and Dmenu-Wayland. Okay. Okay, now we need to install DWM. To do that, you just need to do build DWM first. Before building DWM, I need to extract DWM source code. To do that, then .xbps and extract and the package name, which is DWM. It's gonna extract the DWM source code. Okay, now DWM is extracted. Let me cd into that directory, cd into master directory, build and DWM. If I list, I should see configuration and DWM.c, DWM.dr, w.h, etc. Let me cd back and cd two directories back, cd one more. Okay, let's clean up the terminal. Let me cd into the source packages and dwm. And let me list. You should have a template file, which is, let me, just for building DWM and getting DWM from the Suckless. And the file, let me list the content of the file. You just have DWM.desktop entry. Okay. Let me cd back. Now I have to copy the config.def from source packages to this, to the DWM directory and the files directory. To do that, just type cp master directory build directory DWM config.def and we'll copy it to source DWM files and we rename it to config.h so we can modify the configuration file for DWM. Okay, let me now modify the config file. To do that is just type your text editor, in my case it's vim, SR packages and DWM files config h because I want to modify the font. Okay, let me change the font here to Terminus font and style to bold and maybe increase this by 2, increase this one 2 by 2, change the Dmenu font, Terminus. Let's not do bold. I'm going to change the key bindings because, as you know, I have a French keyboard. So, if I want to change switch tags in DWM, if I hit Alt or whatever the mod key is, and 1, I'm not going to switch to tag 2 or tag 1 for that matter. So, my keyboard is the problem, so I have to change this to my. Okay, the first tag is ampersand. Oh, ampersand, yes, it's ampersand. And the second tag is. What's the second tag? Second tag is in car. In Kate. The third one is. Quotable. Okay, let me just do this 3 and okay, let me save and exit. Okay, as you can see, I modified the configuration for DWM. So now we have to install DWM. To do that, we just do slash xbps and dot slash xbps source and pkg and DWM. Now he's gonna take that configuration file and apply it to DWM. Take those changes that we made and apply it to DWM. Okay, now it's finished. Now let's install DWM. to do that, we need to do sudo xbps install and dash R option, capital R, and where DWM is. DWM is in the host directory, slash bin, bin packages, and the name of the package is just DWM, and we type your password. Okay, now it says that DWM is already installed. We need to force it to reinstall DWM with the dash F option. Okay, now DWM is installed. Let's install ST to do the same thing that we did for DWM. Let me extract the source code. No, that's not correct. Okay, that's good. Now we're extracting the source code, so we can copy that config file to our template folder. Okay, now it's finished extracting that ST's source code. So to find that source code, use cd to master directory and build directory. As you can see here, file list, and I have ST, cd into ST, ls, and we have a config.def file. So cd back, cd, and again, let me list the source pack source and ST, see if we have files directory. No, we don't need to create that directory. Mkdir dash p and ST slash files, the same thing as we did with the DWM, but I did DWM, I didn't have to create that files directory. With ST I have to, because it doesn't exist. So now let's copy that config file to that directory that we created. ST config def.h and copy the source ST slash files, and we rename it as config.h. Now we open that file, ST slash files config. Now we can modify the font, of course. Let's change it to Dmenu, and we scale up the size to 26. Okay, let's change the style of the font, style calls bold. Okay, now we save and exit. Now let's do the same thing as we did, xbps source and package. Let's do dash f to force it, because we did modify the config file, and we hit enter. process has finished. Let's if I list the what is that host directory and then packages, I can see st, as you can see, st-0.8.5-1. Now let's do the same thing as we did with the DWM, sudo xbps install-r and host directory slash bin pkgs and dash f to force it. The dash f is just for if you installed it before and you wanna force it to reinstall st again. So the package is st and type my password and type yes. Okay, now we're done with st. Let's do the Dmenu. I'm just going to install Dmenu. I don't want to modify the configuration or anything. Just do xbps source and pkg Dmenu. Let me do -f2-f and pkg Dmenu. Okay, now the menu is ready. Let's see, let me show you bin packages. As you can see, we have the menu -5.1-1. Okay, let's do the same thing as we did with the previous ones. xbps install -R and host host. Host directory /bin pkg as packages and -f and the menu. Yes, and that's it. To launch or DWM, or you have to create an .xinitrc file. You can copy one. We have one in slash. Let me see. cp/etc/x11/xinitrc. You can copy it to and rename it .xinitrc in your home directory. You can take a look at it. As you can see here, we have to delete these five lines. The last five lines. And put, let me do it in this file. Let me copy /etc/x11/xinitrc to my home directory xinitrc. Okay, vim.xinitrc. Go down and delete this last lines and start. Do this, start here. This is a virtual machine and I have a French keyboard, so I'm going to set those two. Set xkb map to French and set the resolution because this is a VM, as I said before. No. now this is the line you have to put in your xinit.rc, which is exec dwm. That's the only line you have to put, and save and exit. Now all I have to do is type startx, and dwm will launch with our configuration. Okay, that's not really good. The resolution is really screwed up. Let me launch ST here. Okay, ST is loaded with our configuration. Okay, now. Okay, I can switch tags with my keybind, as you can see. I can launch Dmenu. And so let me search surf. Did I uninstall? No. Okay, that's nice. Let me just do one more thing so I can reload DWM without having to okay. Let me go down. Okay, create one more line. Go up. Let me do one, two, and then I think it's just like this. Dev slash no, I think no. And one, maybe done. Okay, quit and save this. Let me quit out of the DWM. Start text again. Okay, it's launching correctly. Now I can quit and solve the issue. Now we have DWM start htop. This is htop and new patch. As you can see here, DWM ST. Okay, in order for me to patch DWM or ST or any Suckless tool, I have to create a patch directory inside this inside the template directory for the program I want to patch. CD into void and source, and let me do ST. Okay, if I list, I have a files directory and template and some terminal info. Let me create a directory in there. Okay, dir patches. We create this directory to put our patches in it. Okay. And this again, I have a patches directory. So let me go to, let me see if I installed in the browser. No, Chrome. By the way, this is a fresh install of void, so I didn't install a browser. Okay, let me cd back and install surf from this xbps source. And pkg surf. Okay, now I have to do sudo xbps install dash r dash capital R host directory and slash bin packages. to surf, type our password. It's gonna download all the those dependencies, and last one is surf, of course. Hit yes and come back when it it's done. Okay, now surf is installed, so let's grab a patch. Surf suckless. Let's do st.suckless.org/patches, and we go to the second tag to have it open in there. Okay, come on. Can't see anything, what the hell. Okay, we can see now. Let's get some a patch we can see. Okay, what patch? Okay, let's get the alpha patch. Okay, the alpha patch is just the for transparency. You can get this one, it's a .8.5. The Apache is just a diff file, or maybe we add in a more and let's cd into source st/patches, and we just create that patch, vim alpha, or we can touch and create the diff file and paste that diff. I didn't type it correctly, that's just alpha, and we paste the what we copied, which is just the alpha patch. And now, let me cd back. CD one more directory back. Now we have to rebuild and reinstall ST. Let's do that. XBPS source and -f pkg st. -f is just to force it to rebuild and regenerate. So we can apply our patch to. Actually, before we do xbps-source -f-pkg, we need to extract it first. so we can copy our config dot h again, extract Okay, now let's do xbps/xbps. Now we need to extract it to be able to be to apply our patch. Extract mst. We are just extracting the source code here with our patch applied to it. Okay, now we extracted the source code, so let me see into the master directory and build packages. Ls API list cd if I can type st file list, and we have our alpha patch dot diff. Now I need to copy, let me just see what's if our patch is applied. We're going to find this float alpha equals 0.8. Now let's exit. Let me copy this. Let me cd back. And let me copy this config file to our st directory in the files directory. Copy from master to build st config def to our source st files config h, copy it into that. Now we have to, we can do now slash xbps source and dash f pkg st, and we click hit enter. Let me open another terminal to install a compositor. I'm going to install sudo xbps-install pycom. ATS, just we can have a transparency. And PyCom is installed, and we close the terminal. Okay, now it's done. So let me install it. Or actually, before installing it, let me change the transparency. To do that, I need to go to that config file and files config h. As you can see, we have this float alpha equals 0.8. Let me change it to 0.5, so we can see clearly redo this again. Now that is done, so let's install it. Xbps install dash r capital R option host directory slash bin directory. Bin packages now. Packages and dash f for to force it, because we did already install it, so let's force it to reinstall st and type your password and hit yes, y for yes. And now let me just modify my xmrc file so I can start PyCon and just do it in here. Okay, PyCon, and we dash dash no sync, because this is just a virtual machine. So now let me reboot. Sudo reboot. Okay, let's type my username and the password and type startx. And we should see DWM. Okay, we have DWM and we have this gray background. Now let's start ST. Okay, as you can see, we have transparency. But the font is small. I think we messed that up, but we can fix that. Source packages, sl packages, st, and file config, no, vim config, h, I think maybe because I copied that config file that it changed it. Let me change it back. I need more space. Is that any good? Okay, let me just change the font size here to 24. Or maybe just change the font anyway. Pixel, and just one. Okay, let me cd back. No, there's one directory. What the hell? It's not typing. Okay, now we do slash xbps source and dash f pkg st. Okay, now let's reinstall ST and we do the same command as we did before, sudo xbps install dash r capital R host directory bin packages dash f to force it to reinstall ST. Hit enter and type your password and we hit Y to say yes and we just close ST and reopen it again. As you can see, the font changed. As you can see, and the same thing that you would do for DWM or Dmenu, if you want to apply patches to it, just do it through the XBPS package manager. Okay, thank you for watching. I hope you learned something.